good day to all of you, the viewers of Berlin Daily Culture. Have you ever bought a painting? Were you ever dreamed about buying a painting to your own house or the place where you live? Right now, here we have a specialist in actually selling them, Julia Materna from Desa Unicum. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you. I'm very glad to be here.
And of course, Desa Unicum is a big auction house in Poland and in Europe, selling mostly Polish art. And right now you are preparing for a big auction about the old art, Polish art, mm-hmm. and modern art, especially from the 19th century. So my question is, who is buying them? Are they foreign investors and the people who have collections, or those actually are Polish people and they stay in Poland?
Well, it's a complex question, but I would like to say that we mostly sell Polish art. Of course, we have a foreign representation of artists, but mostly it's Polish art and Polish buyers, which is good because this art stays in Poland. So those are most, like, the people who buy art in Poland are mostly private collectors. And sometimes institutions. Last time, for instance, we were having an auction of works on paper, and since we have a special law in Poland which enables the museum to buy the painting first or a work of art, so the museum won this bidding, 700 zlotys for a work by Witkacy, which is great that the museums have this budget to buy art as well and present it to many viewers. But mostly those are Polish clients, sometimes institutions, sometimes foreign clients, because we are trying to open ourselves for foreign art as well. So it depends.
Okay, it depends. So, but for example, when we have this, with this auction we were talking about in the previous episode, so the 19th century Polish art, Malczewski, Cossack, Wimpicka, and other, Tetmeyer, other great names, which kind of were also sentimental for a Polish audience. Where did they end up?
Well, it's hard to say, but I think mostly in private collections. The clients always want to stay anonymous, so I cannot tell, but private Polish collectors, sometimes they decide, which is a good sign, they decide to place a painting or an artwork in a deposit in a museum, so like open it for public viewing.
Oh, interesting. So there is a possibility that they buy,
of course.
It's their piece of art, but they end up as a deposit in museums.
Yes, so. Or sometimes as a donation, which is good. And this is what happened with some of the pictures that I was actually taking for my auctions. And it's always a good sign because, like, those paintings remain, like, they are open for public viewing and many people can admire them.
Oh, I see. That's what is a wonderful thing. Then they are not closed somewhere in some way house for only few people, but more can appreciate them and see them. And when it comes to this collection, which we actually have behind us right now, what those pictures have in common when it comes to the aesthetic? Because there is like element of warm, at least for me, in them.
There is. I mean, what do they have in common? They have, of course, is the epoch, because they were created in the, like, at the end of the 19th or the beginning of the 20th century. But I think the major quality is that they all have, like, museum value. They are of the highest artistic quality. And of course, most of them are realistic paintings. And there is this warmth, the connection with Polish history, which is very important. And hence your sentiments.
Of course, and the realism, which we actually like, I would say.
Of course.
That the figurative paintings and of people who are there, like, living on those paintings a little bit.
Yes. And sometimes, like, as we can see on those paintings, there is also a very important element of, like, living on the countryside, and the peace connected to that, which was a very important factor for Polish painters, like, creating things at this time. So somehow finding the truth and the calm in the on the Polish countryside. That was very important, and it was representative of like many hidden values like patriotism and so on.
And they immortalized in a way all of those beautiful gowns and
traditions.
Yeah, and traditions. I mean, and the clothing as well of those people, very colorful on in many yes. regions of Poland. Which
mostly, I would say, mostly like the towns near Krakow, like Ted Meyer's painting. Like we can see that it's a wedding in one of the like Krakow's suburb, like on the one of the Krakow suburbs. So we can see like the celebration, like with many peasants in those beautiful clothes. So it was like immortalizing the traditions, especially when we weren't having Poland wasn't independent at that time. So it was a very important message that the painters were sending.
Well, wonderful. So what is left? Left is only to invite all of you, the viewers of Poland Daily, for the auction if you are eager to buy one of the paintings, but also, of course, to the exhibition. So you can admire, see them before those paintings end up in private hands. And thank you very much for watching Poland Daily Culture.